If you have a Showit website and you're not optimizing each page, you are missing out on a big opportunity to increase your search traffic. The good news? Showit has built-in SEO tools that make it easy to optimize your website. In this video, we're going to dive into Showit's backend. Should I say backend? In this video, we're going to dive into Showit to see step-by-step how to use the Showit SEO settings. What's up, friends? My name is Davey Jones of Davey and Krista, where we help people build brands and websites that reach more people, generate more leads, and help you grow your business. In today's video, we are going to jump into our Showit accounts and provide you with a tutorial on how you can optimize your page titles and SEO descriptions using Showit's built-in SEO tools. Using Showit's SEO settings is super simple and can definitely have an impact on how you rank in Google search results. But after working with countless clients, I cannot tell you how many people overlook these simple settings. If you've never heard of Showit, it's an awesome website platform, gives you total creative control over building the website exactly how you envision it. Be sure to check out the links below in the description for more information about Showit and our Showit website templates. And next, what do we mean by SEO or search engine optimization? Really, what we're talking about is trying to make sure that a page on our website ranks as highly as possible in a Google search result for a given search. Are there other search engines than Google? Yes, but are there really? SEO includes a lot of things, too much to cover in a single video. So in this video in particular, we're talking about how you can set page titles and meta descriptions or SEO descriptions using Showit's built-in SEO tools. If you're looking for more information on SEO, be sure to subscribe to this channel, check out the resources in the link in the description below, and check out our course on Showit SEO, and it'll go over everything you need to know about optimizing your Showit website. The page title is exactly what it sounds like, the title of the web page. The page title not only appears in Google search results, but it also might appear, like, let's say if you share something to Facebook, it would appear in the title of the thumbnail. Page title should be in the ballpark of around 60 characters so that they're not cut off. You want to make sure that you utilize the keywords that people are searching for in the page title that you assign the page. If you're looking for tools that to help you with keyword research, be sure to check out tools like SEMrush, Moz, or Ubersuggest. There are also other free keyword research tools out there. And we always like to end our page titles with our brand name, because the more people see your brand name, the more trust your business is building. Meta descriptions, or SEO descriptions, are the description of the page title that's found right under the title in the Google search results. Typically, you want to keep meta descriptions in the ballpark of 150 characters. But really, meta descriptions are meant to provide context of what people are going to find on the page. Meta descriptions are not a ranking factor, but they're really important. The more clickable the meta description is, the more likely it is that somebody's going to click on your result, thus increasing something called your click-through rate. And the higher your click-through rate, well, typically, higher click-through rates, Google rewards. And so it increases the likelihood that your result is going to show up higher in a Google search results page. So as far as meta descriptions go, you want to make them as clickable as possible. Try to keep the language benefit focused and pique people's curiosity so that they're more likely to click the result. Remember, you want to do this for every page of your website, and you want to make sure that your page titles and your meta descriptions from page to page are completely unique, because you don't want them competing for these same keywords. All right, so how the heck do we actually do this? Let's dive into Showit and take a look. All right, this is what it should look like when you log into your Showit account. And if you notice here on the right-hand side, whenever you click a page, so over here on the left-hand side, you're going to find the page that you want to edit. I'm just on the home page here. Over on the right-hand side, you're going to see a few modules. Down here towards the bottom, one of those modules is SEO settings. So if we click on that and we open those, we're going to see boxes where we can set a page title and a meta description. We can even select a share image that would be used when we share to a social media platform like Facebook. In the page title, I want to point out a few things. One, we're using the keywords that we want to target, that we want this page specifically to target. All right, so based on keyword research, these are the keywords that we came up with here. And for local businesses, it's really important that you make sure you use the location that you're targeting in your page title. You'll also see that there's some form of separator here. All right, so we just use this line. And then after that, we have our brand name. And we tried to use the same format for every page that we're optimizing. So while the page title will be unique, we'll always end with a separator like this and our brand name. Down here in the meta description, you see that we can use more characters. We try to use all the characters that are available to us. Again, meta descriptions can be in the ballpark of 150 characters, and we want to make sure that it's as clickable as possible, which will hopefully result in a higher click-through rate. Let's take a look at another page real quick. So if we went to our family photography page, you'll see that we're optimizing for different keywords here. So we're ending our page title the same with our separator and our brand name, but our page title here is Annapolis, Maryland Family Photography or Family Photographers, and those are the keywords that we're targeting with this page specifically. Same thing, our meta description is filled in here, and we have a unique share image for this page. Remember, meta descriptions really important, not necessarily as a ranking factor, but hopefully a good meta description will increase your click-through rate. So you might be asking yourself, well, what about our blog? If we go to our blog here, you'll see that there's a note. SEO settings for blog posts and pages can be modified using the Yoast SEO plugin in your WordPress admin. So if you have a WordPress blog with your Showit website, you're going to optimize your blog posts and any WordPress pages in WordPress. Now, if you are on the basic blog plan for Showit, then you are going to use Yoast SEO. It comes pre-installed. If you are on the advanced blog tier, you can use Yoast SEO or any of the other professional SEO tools that are out there that are available for WordPress. Yoast is a good one. We typically recommend something like Rank Math, but really any SEO tool, any SEO plugin that you're using for WordPress, if it's good, should allow you these same capabilities. And when you're optimizing your WordPress posts, you're going to apply the same principles that we went over here talking about, you know, optimizing your Showit pages. Something that's important to realize, if you don't add a page title, you don't add a meta description, what it's going to do, it's going to pull in the title of that page, whatever you named it internally. So for instance, your homepage is likely called home. And if you were to share that to Facebook, for instance, what would show up in the thumbnail is just home. And that doesn't do you any good because it doesn't let people know, or search engines know for that matter, what that page is about. So to avoid that, make sure you actually fill out these fields under SEO settings. And last but not least, make sure that you come up here and hit publish when you're done. All right, there you go. That's everything you need to know about optimizing your Showit website using Showit's built-in SEO tools. For more information like this, be sure to subscribe to this page and check out the SEO resources that we link to in the description below this video. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below this video. We want to answer them. Peace. Ha ha.